not to indicate to the people who run it, to the people who own it, that unless you're free, the machine will be prevented from working at all, from working at all, from working at all.
Don't lay down and die because a new world order, the business of the day for the elite, when they're coming to take your freedoms away.
Hello again, human beings from the planet Earth, and especially those of you that are participating in the Million Mask March on November 5th. Now, I had hoped to be able to go to my state capital, Salem, Oregon, in the morning, and then meet the larger group over in Portland later in the afternoon. But because I'm a single dad that has to work, and we have a loopy schedule right now, painting, where we had a couple days off at the beginning of the week, and now we have to finish a project, I will not be able to attend. And that saddens me, but what I think I can do that would be very effective and helpful for the movement and the idea is to rush home from work that day, open up the live show so that we can take live reports from wherever. I now offer, via the live shows, call numbers in 26 countries. So it should be pretty easy for any of you to give us some live reports. And this is a global movement, so it would be really nice for us here in the U.S. or anyone anywhere to be able to hear what our brothers and sisters are doing. Now, I do want to add that some of you have seen a lot of immature fuckery, I'll call it, associated with me and others. We'll leave it at that. I want to assure everybody that none of what I do is ever personal, especially as it relates to a movement. But within that movement, there are individuals that create this fuckery. I will say that I did compromise twice out of compassion and compromise and a care for the movement in general. But the issue at hand is very concerning to the movement. And twice I was fucked over, and the individual decided to continue foolish, childish attacks, which is the reason I addressed the issue in the first place, because of the division and hate that it causes among a movement that I feel could really bring some change and unify everybody. So with that being said, that's enough said. I won't waste any more time on that individual. The information's out there. You can decide for yourself. The issue at hand is, where is the Million Mask March going? What has happened this day with all these indicators that we could have mayhem and arrests and violence? I hope everything goes peaceful. It would be great at the end of the day for the rest of the world to hear that everything was great, nobody got arrested, that we saw new people joining in the movement. And so I will run home from work, and I would assume by 5 p.m., that's Pacific time, 5 p.m. Pacific time on November 5th, I will open up the live shows and the calls. In between any calls, you know, I'll probably just fill the air with some local news, whatever I can find that has happened that day. But I really hope the focus is you guys jumping on the phone and giving us a minute or two of your time. I can have up to 1,000 callers at any given moment, so there's no excuse not to call in. You're not going to get bounced off, and the whole world is waiting to hear what has happened on the Million Mask March, Guy Fawkes Day, November 5th. Much love. Many thanks to you all, and right below in the show more will be a link to the live show page where we can chat and exchange links. And the second link down will be a link to the international call numbers. So I believe there are 26 countries that have a call number for you to be able to call in and get your message out live to the world. Much love, and I'll see you on the night of the 5th.